It's MFL action live from Tokyo, Japan at the world-famous Krokyo Dome. And the Terminators are being oiled and charged up in anticipation of a successful campaign today.
Oh, that sounds like being at the Geisha's massage parlor last night, Grim.
Happy ending?
Well, if you mean getting tossed into the piranha tank in the lobby, yes, then very happy, Grim. Very happy ending.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The New Goreleans Zombies battle the Tokyo Terminators. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. And MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pig flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And that'll bring up second and one.
Oh, man, he really wants it.
First down. This guy just loved to hit.
Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
He was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
6-yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
And that'll be second down and four. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and ten. Friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. Second down and long. Third down and the punter is warming up. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier better move his ass out of... And then he jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble! That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. 10. And that's a fumble recovery in return for a touchdown. What a great running backs left and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. They're going to be able to return this one. Like he just saw 400 scary with the vicious kill.
Did you know late hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
The kicker died on that play.
Man, that's terrible. Now what do they do?
Well, another player will assume the kicking role for the remainder of the game. The coach is praying he won't need a long field goal to win this one. First down and a mile. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
And that's an incomplete pass. Looks like the defense got away with that one there.
Receiver like that, he could get hurt.
Third down and, well, good luck. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. Oh, and he intercepts the ball.
Thank you very much, Sister Defender.
Oh, and he fouled. Now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys.
It's fantastic. Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, man, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And it's first and 10. Went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Yeah. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim. Yeah.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, Grim.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking?
Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge! That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone in Mexico. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but
not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
First down in less than a year. Defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him.
Yeah.
it's first and ten. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown!
Now you see that little baby? You know what? I'm too fast for it. I'm the greatest. Greatest, I tell you.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. And he breaks away. And like bricks his bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and ten. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And that'll be second and eight to go. And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. And that'll be second and eight to go. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. So do the fans. And it's first and ten. That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and ten. The defender says, I don't think so. Third down and ten. And he zings it in there for a 9-yard completion. They're moving the ball now with authority. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
Nice punt. Should move them back nicely. The punt goes into the end zone, and it's a touchback. And it's first and ten. Oh, nice hit. Second down and a lot. Oh, and that's when it feels like, oh man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and ten. finds an opening. And... oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and ten. Unleashes a rocket and creates a sonic blast across the field to everyone but his receiver.
Holy cramoli! The shockwave's knocked all the defenders down!
Second down in a mile. And then to first down from a great catch. See a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. First and eight to go. Out of it.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And that'll be second and eight to go. And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, man. Like a haiku.
And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, I mean, he was a great ball player. You know, that's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Wow, the quarterback, he's off to the races. He's running out of gas now. No touchdown today! Looks like that defender ate his bleedies this morning. And it's first and ten. He may not... oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot! That's why we love the MFL! And it's first and ten. And that's another turnover for the defense! Unstoppable force meets the explodable object. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
It's first and ten. Caught for the first down. First down and three. Bricks, it's the two-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
First down and three. Wrestles away from that tackle. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight. Mm. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham and sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow.
Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
And it's first and ten. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. And viewers at home, don't worry, he doesn't have fleas. He's just not a very good dancer.
I have fleas, and I can't dance that good.
I would think you'd stay on the other side of the booth, Bricks. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just... The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since.
QB is using. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And it's first and ten. Has to make something happen here with one timeout left. Second down in a very lot. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole up here. Talking to you.
Came up big. The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, who don't do that?
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And that'll be a touchback.
I don't feel comfortable giving a massage while we're running.
Defense lost another linebacker on that play, and only two remain on their roster. Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. And it's first and ten. Misery and says, who's next? Touchdown! And he rips off a game-breaking run for the score. The offense lost their last running back on the plays. You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him.
Ah, going in circles.
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Lynn? A carnival? Huh? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and ten. Chains, that's good for a first down. This game is that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
The defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Second down and two.
It looks like the lineman wanted to get the ball a high five.
That he did, Bricks. That he did. Third and two. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten. And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender right now. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. Second down and ten. How you run it, folks. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. The Tokyo Terminators terminated the opposing team into a bloody mess, as they are programmed to do. They win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. The alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say. once again the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every up.